very glad that you're here. And so good to have Hope Sound Bible College Legacy Quartet with us all. I'm so grateful that they're here with us, scheduled this several months ago. So glad that it worked out for them to be here. And we welcome each of you to the service. Those that are tuning in online, we welcome you as well. We're just interested in the Lord having His way in this service, aren't we? And the way to make that happen is to give God access to our hearts and our minds right from the outset. So let's stand together. Let's invite His presence. Give Him access to our hearts and minds as we've gathered into His house tonight. Father, what a privilege it is to be with Your people tonight in Your house. We thank You for the privilege of worshiping You. And Lord, I pray that You would help us in this service to worship You in spirit and in truth. It's a little different style of service than we're used to doing, but this is a service that we are interested in allowing You to have access to our minds and to our hearts through the avenue of music. And so we're so grateful for Hope Sound to be here tonight in Legacy Quartet. We're asking You to minister through them to us. And we want the songs that they sing. We want to find some phrases in them that will help us in our spiritual walk. We want to draw closer to You as a result of this service tonight. And so from the very outset of this service, we give You access to our minds and to our hearts. Bless us as we worship together, and we'll give You praise in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Remain standing. Let's join in the singing as 10 minutes.
Turn to 362. I was thinking about all the 80-year-old guys who were on this morning instead of Rodney and Donald or something. Some days I get up and feel like I'm 80 years old. Some days on a Sunday afternoon after a nap. 362, my soul is filled with glory.
Oh, transforms our life.
It makes us in the image of Christ and helps us along the way to grow, increase, and develop, and be better and better Christians and Christ-like people. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, it's good to have all of you. Paul, it was good to hear you on the organ tonight.
Amen.
I have the deepest memories of Paul playing on the organ at Grandma's house, Mother's house, his grandma, when he was just a little guy, and he rattled the window, you know, and just played a full blast. And Mother said, "Don't you tell him to turn that down. Let him play." Oh my, that's the kind of grandmother my mother was. For her grandkids, she said, "Don't you tell them to quit running through the house. They can do whatever they want to do." She informed me that she raised me, she was going to enjoy my kids. So. Oh my. Well, it's good to see all of you. You know, I believe it's Tammy's sons come in. Is that right? Grandchildren. We're glad to have you. Welcome. And I want to mention it's been so good to have Tammy with you several times. She's been staying here with her brother for a time after Brother Tallman's passing. So glad to have all of you. Tammy's been good to have you with us here. But we're going to pray together and trust the Lord in our prayer time for our needs. And I'm glad that we can. Brother Ron, would you lead us in prayer tonight as we pray? Let's remember those requests that were mentioned this morning. Marvin Stamper continues to need our prayers. Their affections returned in the spot on his foot, and they're just needing to battle that real aggressively. And we want to pray that, you know, God can touch an independent medicine, but he can also help that medicine to do what it's supposed to do. So let's pray for Marvin. He's been a discouraging thing. But Mike here has also got some x-rays this week on his foot where he has two screws put in his ankle where he broke it, and both of those screws are broken, and Mike's not sure what that means, but it's a very worrisome thing to him. So let's remember Mike, especially as we pray tonight. We want to remember the Underwood family. Darrell Underwood's mother passed away. We tend to remember the Tallman family. We tend to remember the Camps and the Camps. Let's pray for Randy. Randy is largely responsible for the IHYC camp. So the guys the size of these boys ought to be able to keep things controlled over there. But let's pray for Randy and for the camp next week. Brother Rodney, as he preaches that camp, Brother Sam, as he has a session speaking to the young people. So let's remember all of those as we pray. Are there other spoken requests? Let's see. Let's remember Josh Stanley. Josh is starting his internship today in Beaver Town. Let's pray that God will touch Josh and help him and anoint him. And I've got great hope for what God's going to use in Josh. So let's pray. Any other spoken requests you want to mention? Maybe an unspoken murmur by a raised hand. Please give the day to the Lord. God knows what our needs are. Let's stand together. We pray, Lord, lead us. Let's live together and join him as he leads us.
Our Father, my God, we're so grateful tonight that we can come to you in this service, Lord, to worship you and praise you, Lord, for your blessings, for your help, for your provision. Lord, we're so grateful that we have you to serve. We're grateful, Lord, for the fellowship of believers, Lord, as we're gathered here tonight. Lord, we just pray that you continue to have your way in our hearts and lives. In this service, Lord, as has been mentioned, Lord, we trust you to remind us of your care, of your love, your provision, and somehow, Lord, keep that, yes, and make it possible, Lord, that each one will be encouraged, yes, as we go into this brand new week.
Yes.
Lord, we,
yes,
thank you that we have the privilege of sharing one another's burdens, Lord. Mm-hmm. We realize that there's those in this congregation, some here tonight and some unable, but Lord, we pray that you would continue to encourage those that are grieving. Those that have lost loved ones, yes, Lord, we pray that, yes, you would just, yes, continue, please, to be very near, that you would bring the courage to go on and to face the trials, yes, that grieving brings. Lord, we pray that, please, you would just, please, undertake.
Please.
Lord, you know those that are hurting, Lord, those that are aged and those not so old, Lord, that need your touch on their bodies. Lord, we pray that you would undertake, that you would provide for Brother Mike Jury, for Brother Stafford, Lord, you know these needs are so real and so urgent in our perspective, Lord, but we know that in your care, that these are completely under control. We just pray that you'd have your way. Keep each one of these men encouraged. Lord, we pray for each one of the others. Lord, we know there's many needs in this group that we haven't had requests for, but Lord, we just pray that you would make it a good week ahead, Lord, as we realize that you are sufficient for every need. Lord, we love you tonight. We pray that you continue to get good to souls, Lord, as these camps go on, Lord, especially this camp, Lord, bless Brother Moper, Demon Ministry there.
Yes.
Help, Lord, that Brother Sankey would be able to communicate very wisely, as we know he has to do, Lord, to these young hearts.
Yes.
Lord, we pray that you would just accomplish your purpose.
Yes.
And then, Lord, we do pray for Hope Sound, Lord, where we've been encouraged through the years, Lord, and the educational, the spiritual benefits of that school. And Lord, we pray that you would just bless the group tonight as they present your truth and your word, and singing and whatever else that transpires, Lord. Continue to get good to the school, get good to each one of these young men, Lord, just continue what you have done to use that place, that particular institution, Lord, for your honor and glory, and get all the benefit, Lord, that you want tonight in this service, Lord, we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen. May be seated. Let me dismiss the children at this time for junior church. Thank you. Go down to the fellowship hall for junior church. The Lord be with them as they have time for service. All right, let me mention just a couple of things tonight following the service. For the step that we'd like to meet with the board, some board members, those of you that are able to be here for a short meeting, they'd like to do that following the service. So once we get that. Also, if you're here tonight and we're not here this morning and did not receive Father's Day gift, those fathers that are here tonight, some out there on the foyer table, please avail yourself of that. Also, I want to mention one other announcement. We are trying to do some updating and some new things to our website. Some videoing at some times where maybe think about these people, maybe videoing people walking into church or videoing using a different maybe phone than the one for actual services, videoing the service or a Sunday school class or whatever. So I just want to give everybody a heads up that's what's taking place. I need to do a little editing to update to our website. So just wanted to throw that out there so you'll know kind of what's happening. When you see him walking around with a camera and asking you to smile and do all those things. Well, it's a real delight to have Hope Sound Bible College here with us, Legacy Quartet. We spent last week with them and enjoyed being with them. And I'm so grateful that they can be here. And we're just trusting, Lord, to help them as they minister in song. And I mentioned it during the prayer time, the opening prayer time. But, you know, as they are going to be singing, there's going to be a lot of songs that are going to be sung. And there's going to be a phrase of the song that I hope you'll minister. Maybe a different phrase for some of you than it is for me, but a song at a time, I want us to allow God to use their music ministry tonight to speak to our heart and encourage us and help us. It's a little different service. Obviously, no preaching tonight unless Baldwin's on that one preaches in his PR service, which is fine if you do. But it's just a little bit of a different format. But having said that, we are interested in God's presence being here. God doing his work among us.
Yes, sir.
And so let's allow God to use these men to minister to our hearts. Legacy, so glad you're here. Come and minister at this time.
Yes.
We're going to go ahead and introduce ourselves here really quick. Like Pastor said, we're Legacy Quartet from Hope Sound Bible College in Hope Sound, Florida. My name is Ryan Burley. I'm from Lima, Ohio, and I am now a senior in the pre-professional studies department.
Well, it is a pleasure to be here this evening. I've heard a lot of good things about this church. It's exciting to finally be here. But my name is Josh Mott, and I am from the great state of North Carolina. And I, somehow, some miracle, just graduated about 3 weeks ago.
Well, good evening, everybody. It's so good to be with you. My name is Evan Burley, and I'm also from Lima, Ohio, and I'm going into my junior year in the pre-professional studies department.
Well, good evening. It's indeed a pleasure to be here. My name is Evan Finley. I'm going into my junior year in the music department, and I'm from the Bahamas.
I call in times of trouble. There is a
who controls the winds and the seas, sees fit to come down and to stand in the fire beside me. When I'm going through what seems like I won't get to the end of, he comes down and says, "It's okay, son, I will be with you. Just hold my hand and I'll lead you through it all the way if you trust me." Next song that Grace sings called "Jesus Is All I Need." And the first verse goes on to say, "When I'm tired and I'm weary on my journey home, when the road is rough and long and I feel so all alone, when my strength is almost gone, that's when Jesus is all I need." And I'm so thankful that when I'm at my wit's end, when I feel like I can't go any further, I just look to my Heavenly Father and He's all that I need tonight. I'm so thankful for that.
I need no other friend. I need no other.
You know, I was thinking, not only can there be a point in our life when we can consciously realize that Jesus is all that I will ever need, and the beauty and the power and the strength of that thought, but then there can come a point of total, complete, radical abandonment that you can then say, Jesus is all that I want. He's all that I ever want. I crave this like anything. Nothing else in this world really matters in this world except for wanting Jesus and knowing Him and making His name known to the world around us, wherever that may be. And that tonight is my testimony that not only is He all that I need, but He's then all that I want and all that I have to crave after. Now this next song we're getting ready to sing just goes with it so perfectly. It talks about all the things that can be found in the name of Jesus. There's truth, there's beauty, there's happiness. There's a forgiveness. There's all sorts of, there's care and comfort. There's welcome and pardon. But there's one word that I think that I just, after all these years of singing, just still thrills my heart tonight. It is the word that best describes my relationship with my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And that there's a friendship to be found in the name of Jesus. That He's such a good friend. And when I think about what a good friend is to me, it's a friend that doesn't push me away when I feel like I've let Him down, even though I couldn't let Him down anyhow. But I just keep pushing away. He just, His love, His mercy, His grace, it never runs out and it never gives up on me this evening. And that's my friend Jesus tonight. Amen. I don't know if you know that friend named Jesus tonight, but if you don't, you can before you leave here this evening. But those of you who do, I ask that you just worship with us and bless the name of Jesus this evening.
Jesus. Jesus is all I need. security and all of the august nature of the surroundings of this summit with these heads of state. And I thought to myself, I get an audience with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords every morning.
Praise God.
Not a one of those people can hold a candle to that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God has come and met with us here tonight in Burlington. And I'm thankful for that. I've sensed His presence. And I tell you what, friends, the older I get, the more life I experience, the more I value His presence.
Yes, sir.
Because that's what it's about. You know, the psalmist found the secret of life. It was David, of course, and he was in trouble. He was running for his life, an outcast from his own country, pursued by his own king. And he wrote those words, "In your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures evermore." He said, "I have set the Lord always before me, and because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved."
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank God for his sweet presence.
Praise
That's
God.
What it's all about, friends.
Yes, sir.
And the quicker we learn that, the more we'll be ready for heaven, where we will eternally celebrate the presence of God. That's what will make heaven beautiful. Not the streets of gold, walls of jasper, gates of pearl, the crystal sea. Not just seeing grandma again or our loved ones again, and you know I really want to do that. But it's the presence of God.
Amen.
He is the one. Thank you for
his
presence here tonight. Thank you for his faithfulness. Thank you for his faithfulness at Hope Sound. God has blessed us. As you know, you have young people that are in Bible college right here from this church. You have some of you are on staff at Bible colleges. And you know that these have been tough times. You know that COVID has been a challenge. To whatever extent it's been real and to whatever extent it's been political, it's been a challenge. And it has taken a toll in many different ways. And I just want to thank God for his faithfulness through this time. There were times when we sat around the council table wondering, how are we going to pay our teachers? Our students just left town, and with them, the revenue source that pays the bills. And yet, I can report today that accounts payable at Hope Sound is current, and we don't owe anybody outside our organization. We're not in any external debt. We praise the Lord for that. All through this time, we've been fundraising for a new building. We're getting ready to build the Crawford Center. That'll be basically a gymnasium. Used by the college, the academy, and the church. It's a joint effort with Hope Sound Bible Church, and through that process, the Lord has helped us to raise $2.2 million toward that. That is exciting. We're going to build that building and move into it debt-free with the help of the Lord. And so we're encouraged by that. Our enrollment did take a slight dip this fall, the on-campus college enrollment. And that's understandable, because at that time, there was a lot of uncertainty. People traveling distances were unsure, am I going to send my child down there and then they're going to have to turn around and come right back. But we thank God it was only a very slight dip, and we were encouraged by that. We're encouraged by the fact that numbers are looking really good for this fall. That's exciting. God's blessing in our academy, it's bursting at the seams. Our principal told me the other day, he said, if you have any staff coming down next year that has school-aged children, you've got to tell me, because we're going to have to save spaces for them. We're having to cap off our classes, and that's a good problem. So our online program continues to grow. And in fact, one of the most exciting things, I just really get excited about this, and I will go to preaching if I'm not careful, Andy, so you know, sometimes the shoe fits wherever. We just launched a master's degree, Master of Arts in Education. I'm a little bit passionate about it because my wife and I both enrolled in it when it was first rolled out. Jacinda was the teacher, and that was her passion, and she wanted to enroll in it. And I said, well, hey, rather than you being stuck in a room somewhere studying, I'll just enroll with you and we'll study together. So that's what we did, and it was very, very, very wonderful experience studying that material together. We were blessed to have a friend, Dr. Mark Smith. He's president of Columbia International University. He's alum of Hope Sound. And he and his team actually helped get us set up. They basically lent us their curriculum, so we were able to launch with a mature program. It's fully accredited. We're very excited to have graduated our first 8 graduates just 3 weeks ago at our graduation. And that was so exciting. It has 2 tracks, classroom instruction for teachers, and educational leadership for administrators, And this spring, we added a third track, and this is what I'm particularly excited about. For far too many years, we have sat across the table from families who have children with special needs, and we've had to look at them and say, I'm sorry, we're just not equipped to meet the needs of your child. And we've sent them to the public school down the road. By the grace and help of God, that day is coming to an end. One of our own graduates, Crystal Budensig, just got her PhD in special ed. She's been working in that field, and she, along with the help of several others, has set up this new program that will be a Master of Arts in Education with an emphasis in special education. I can't tell you how excited that makes me. To my knowledge, that's the first time anybody in the conservative holiness movement has launched in that field. So I could talk on and on about what God is doing financially, academically, as far as the physical plant is concerned, enrollment, all of that. But more than anything, I'm excited about the fact that God is helping us to make a spiritual impact. And you know, we get so caught up in all those other things, and that is not what we're here for.
Right.
That is not what it's about. Those are important means to an end, and that end is touching lives for Jesus Christ. As our motto says, knowing Christ and making him known. The name of this quartet is Legacy. And that's not by accident. I love that name because it's so fitting for this group. Three-fourths of this group are children of alumni. Two of them are second generation, third generation, actually, the Burley boys. Their grandmother attended Hope Sound, and their father attended Hope Sound, and now they're attending Hope Sound. I love that. I think that is so neat. Their grandmother is serving as a pastor's wife and conference president's wife for the Midwest Pilgrim Conference. And their mother and father are serving in the local church. Their mother is the principal of their Christian day school in Lima. And the aspiration of these two boys in the professional studies program is to go back and serve their local church and school and conference. And I think that is awesome.
Amen.
You know, for far too many years, we have underplayed the importance of solid Christian lay people. And that's what they're intending to be. And I love it. And all the pastors said, amen. Thank God for quality Christian lay people. We need more and more of them. I love it when I go to churches and we see our graduates, other graduates from other schools, serving on the board, playing the piano, leading the singing, teaching the youth class, heading up a bus ministry. That's what it's all about, friends. Advancing the kingdom, one soul at a time. Josh Modlin, his parents are both alumni of Hope Sound, and it's so thrilling to see him come back and be a student. And now he's serving as our student recruiter. Josh is graduating from the Pastoral Ministries program, and eventually he's going to pastor. And I love that, because Josh loves people, and people love Josh. It just sort of oozes out of him, you know. And people don't forget Josh Model. And I love that, and I can't wait to see what God is going to do through Josh's ministry. Elkin really, really touches my heart, because Elkin is from the Bahamas. Now, I have a unique connection to the Bahamas because my father was called to the ministry when he was on a mission trip in the Bahamas. And so I am here today, probably in more ways than one, because my dad went down to the Bahamas to minister. But I think it's so neat that about 60 years ago, Dr. Steve Herron, our founder, others like Phil Newton, Mark Vernon, got on little single-engine overloaded Cessna planes and flew across the Atlantic Ocean down to the Bahama Islands, the Turks and Caicos Islands, and began carving out churches. And little by little, that work grew, and today there are churches dotting those islands, there are camp meetings, there are schools, and it is so exciting to see what God is doing. One of the things I love about Elkin and another Bahamian student that we had recently is that they both come from the church that is pastored by one of our graduates. He has a youth program that's well known on the island. And one of the things that these guys have said is, yes, we had gone to bigger churches that had better music programs and more stuff going on, but there was something about Pastor Kemp's church. They lived what they preached. I love that, don't you?
Yeah.
Is that not what we as holiness people are all about?
Amen.
I think that's wonderful. So Elkin comes to us as fruit from the seeds that were sown clear back in the 1960s from Hope Sound. We just graduated another young lady, Tabona Kemp, and she is Pastor Kemp's daughter. And I think it's wonderful that she graduated with an education degree, and she's going back to teach in one of those Christian schools down there. Isn't that beautiful?
Amen.
And the legacy continues. Hallelujah. That excites me. The future is bright. Yes, there are clouds on the horizon. And President Loper could tell you more about this than I can. But we just received a letter from the U.S. Department of Education. I'm sure they did as well. Stating that Title IX is going to be expanded. Title IX is the anti-discrimination clause in the government financial aid administrative structure. And they are expanding Title IX to include LGBTQ rights. And there's supposed to be a few other letters they keep adding, and I can't keep up, so you know what I'm talking about. But they're expanding Title IX to include protections for homosexuals, transgender, and so on. What does that mean for us? Well, honestly, we don't know. In the immediate future, it could mean the withdrawal of Pell Grants and student loans. You may say, well, I don't believe in government funding anyway. Well, bless your heart. It's a fourth of the budget of Hope Sound and probably a similar ratio at GBS and other schools as well. And more importantly, those funds help our students to be able to afford Bible College and to be able to go without lots of student debt hanging over their heads when they graduate and go to pastor one of our little churches. So it's a system that we rely upon, and that could be withdrawn. But even more serious than that is the prospect of litigation concerning our hiring practices, our admittance policies for students. Are there things that can be done? Perhaps. Do we have a Supreme Court that may be friendly? Perhaps. Can we rely upon those things? No. We are relying on the Lord. God hasn't brought us this far to drop us or to let us tip over into the abyss. God is blessing. God is helping as I've watched the funds roll in for this new building project. I can't help but be impressed by the fact that there's a future and a bright future for Hope Sound and for our other schools as well. We're here to link arms, not to compete. But pray for us. Pray for our Bible colleges. Ladies and gentlemen, Christian education is the front line of the battle. It is the front line. We are battling for the souls, the hearts, the minds of our young people. If we don't take the initiative to capture their souls and their hearts and their minds, someone else will.
Right.
So God help us to do that, to do it effectively. Yes, we want to touch them intellectually. But oh, I just pray that God would so fill our halls with His Spirit and His presence that they'll experience something that they'll never get away from. That they'll be marked. That they'll be spoiled for anything that the world has to offer. Will you pray that God will do that? You don't have to be a graduate of Hope Sound. You may be a supporter of another school, and that's fine. God bless you. But will you just pray? It doesn't cost you any money to say a prayer. And say, oh God, just pour out your Spirit on Hope Sound Bible College and Hope Sound Christian Academy. And help those students that graduate from there to go out and make a difference for Jesus. Will you do that?
Amen.
We thank you for your prayers. We thank you for your support. Thank you, Uncle Darrell, for allowing us to come. The guys are going to come and sing a little more. Continue to worship.
Dig a little deeper, woman, dig a little deeper, dig a little deeper in His love. Oh, dig a little deeper in His love, dig a little deeper in His love, dig a little deeper in the storehouse of His love.
Of his love, of his love.
dig a little deeper. Dig, 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 dig a little deeper. Wanna dig, 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 dig a little deeper. Dig a little deeper in the storehouse of His love, of His love.
That leads us through this very land. One thing one thing that we can be happy about as Christians is that we don't serve a false God. We don't serve a God that's never there for us. His hand is unseen, but it's not unfelt. We can feel God, and we know that He's with us. I'm so thankful for that. This next song we're about to sing is called Through. And it talks about going through the fire and through the flood, through the water, through the blood. What I'm so thankful for is that His unseen hand will take us through any trials, any tribulations we have. I'm so thankful that we have a God that's always with us.
Amen.
Oh, But the path of that long Galilee,
face. Hearing those words, well done, good and faithful servant, enter into the joy of the Lord. That's what we're living for. We get caught up in so many peripheral things, sometimes important things, but not eternal things. God, help us to live with eternity's values in view and live for that moment when we see Him face to face. And oh, as the songwriter said, I shall know Him, and redeemed by His side, I shall stand. I'll know Him by the prints of the nails in His hand. And you know what the Bible says? It says, my name is written on that hand. I love that. He's calling my name before the throne, even tonight. Jesus, the blessed Holy Spirit, interceding for me with groanings that cannot be uttered. Hallelujah. Looking forward to that day when we can lay all of these trials aside and enjoy the presence of Jesus. This last song that we're going to sing is a little upbeat, maybe a little bit of a fun song, but listen to the words because it has a deep meaning. It says, don't you weep for me when I'm gone, because I won't have to leave here alone. When I hear that last trumpet sound, my feet won't stay on the ground. I'm going to rise with a shout, and I'm going to fly, and I'm going to rise with my Lord to the sky. Heaven is near. Hallelujah. Heaven is near, and I can't stay here. Goodbye, world. Goodbye.
Told all my troubles goodbye, goodbye to each tear and each sigh. This world where I roam cannot be my home. I'm bound for that home in the sky. I walk and I talk with my Lord. I feast every day on His word.
Standing up here, I get to call the shots because everyone knows that they're going to do that. Somebody was lamenting recently that they do not hear offertories anymore. How many miss offertories during church? They're not in passing the plates. And I am going to ask Elkin to play a song. He played at the teen camp, youth camp. And I did not know that he played the piano, but during this youth camp, they had different people from the Bible colleges play a special. And I really enjoyed his special, Wonderful Grace. Would you do that for us? And while he is doing that, I want you to be thinking about what you want to give in this offering. I'm not going to pass the plates, but you could be thinking about what you want to give as you exit. The offering plates are out there in the foyer as usual. And the church board has already set an offering that we are going to give. And anything that comes in beyond that, we are sending that as well. And so we want you to give generously and give to a very, very worthy cause. And I'm going to ask Elton if he'll come and play. You be thinking right now as he's playing about what God would have you to give to this offering. Thank you, Legacy, for being here in your ministry among us. But if you are, you just miss us in prayer.